After intubation, the endotracheal tube is secured in place by inflating a small cuff that surrounds the tube with 5 to 10 milliliters of air. This provides stability, helps keep the tube in place, and protects the lower airways from aspiration. In this video, we're going to break down a sample TMC practice question about intubation and cuff pressure. So, if you're ready, let's get into the question. A 50-year-old male patient is intubated with a size 8 endotracheal tube and is receiving volume-controlled assist-controlled ventilation. Upon assessment, you note that the patient's cuff pressure is measured at 38 centimeters of water pressure. Which of the following would you recommend? A. Withdraw the tube 1 to 2 centimeters and reassess the patient's breath sounds. B. Recommend reintubation with a smaller endotracheal tube. C. Lower the cuff pressure to less than 30 centimeters of water pressure. Or D. Recommend ventilation via a tracheostomy. To get this one correct, you needed to know the normal values for cuff pressure. And in this case, you needed to recognize that 38 centimeters of water pressure is way too high and could potentially be dangerous for the patient. Therefore, your first action should be to lower the cuff pressure to less than 30 and then check to ensure that there are no leaks. For the TMC exam, you must remember that the normal range for cuff pressure is between 20 to 30 centimeters of water pressure. In this case, there is no indication to withdraw the tube, and using a smaller tube would only cause the patient's peak pressure to increase, which is something that we do not want. Furthermore, there is nothing in the question that suggests a tracheostomy is indicated, so we can rule out that one as well, which means that we could easily determine that the correct answer has to be C. Lower the cuff pressure to less than 30 centimeters of water pressure. If you enjoy practice questions like this, definitely consider checking out our TMC Test Bank. It's a massive bank of practice questions with helpful explanations like this one that students are using to pass the TMC exam. It also comes with 4+ sample TMC practice exams to help you test your knowledge and prepare for the real thing. If you're interested, I'll drop a link below this video if you want to learn more, including some helpful premium bonuses that are only included for a limited time. But if you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.